Ọ̀nà kejì.
To give thanks to God.
Láti fọwọ́ fọlọ́run mú.
Is what is called the spiritual aspect of harvest.
Every
only
what every month.
The aspect of harvest, don't get it every.
I believe this is most important.
When they got what we yellow shape attacked you.
And the thing of this harvest
now, I'm calling and you're doing
abide with me.
The way Wapelu
fits nicely into what I want to say.
So I'm calling and see to them abide with me. Don't tell me the good confession.
It's about meeting the Lord.
It's about coming up alone by
the Lord.
Lord.
Let me hear somebody say, abide with me. I want to read from that scripture. The scripture that we had.
Have you been
Luke 24, verse 20. I'm going to read it quickly. But the disciples constrained.
Give me this video though, so I can scan it.
The disciples constrained, they urged Jesus urgently. Saying, abide with us. For it is towards evening. And the day is far spent. And he went in to tarry, to stay.
That's long.
Jesus will meet with somebody here today. And not only that, Jesus will stay with somebody here today in the name of Jesus. Let me explain this story to you. This was the story of how Jesus appeared to two believers on the road to Emmaus. And the two disciples, having explained their sadness and confusion, following the death of Jesus, Jesus, who was walking along with them, responded by going to scripture.
I'm going to in the Bible.
When the disciples approached the village, that is Emmaus, which way they were going, they urged Jesus strongly to abide with them. Again today, I say Jesus will stay with somebody. He will not leave you alone. You will know his loving presence with you all the days of your life. In the name of Jesus. So what is the meaning of abide? My friends, abide means to accept. Or act in accordance with a rule. A decision. Or a recommendation.
Or advice.
It is about complying. It is about obeying. It is about observing. It is about following and keeping. It's about conforming and adhering to. Praise God. Now, my dear friends,
and you are ready.
The scriptural meaning of abide. The scriptural meaning of abide.
Into one thing that they need to tell me.
For us Christians, is to be submissive. It is total submission to God.
It terrible to complete your Lord.
So how do you and I abide in the Lord? Let me just read to you from James chapter 4, verse 7. And it says, submit yourselves. And this is one of the ways James gave on how to come near to God.
Si Dieu suggère que nous sommes là.
So one of the ways to abide in Christ is harvest. Is to yield to God's authority. It is to yield to God's will. It is about committing your life to Him. And to His control. And above all, you must be willing to follow Him. And let me say this to you. The best way you can show your gratitude to God is harvest. Is to allow God to make His dwelling place in your heart. You know, some people go to church. Mother and daughter, and another daughter who is not a member of my church, and they were quarreling, and somebody phoned me, and I intervened, and this woman, an elderly woman who has been coming to church for a long time, she was tossing her daughter, and I said, Mama, all my preaching, all these years, 17 years in that church, and I see you coming to church, you'll be the first person there. How can you be cursing your daughter? I even said to her, you need to forgive. She said, I cannot forgive. I said, that is serious. I quoted scripture and scripture and scripture. So this kind of woman has not made his God his dwelling place. Some years ago, maybe about 6 years ago, I always tell people I lead people in the Holy Land. And I've been doing it for 19 years, every single year. And this lady went with me. And we were in Jerusalem praying. And she said one of the group members took her seat in the coach. And she started to scream, God will punish you, God will punish you. I said, this is a wasted journey. And this woman is a member of the church, of my church. If I had met her in that church, I've been in that church for 17 years.
In fact,
and I've been looking at her, her situation has not changed. In fact, it is getting worse. That will not be a portion in the name of Jesus. And so I said to her this year, I said, look, what God was saying to me, this woman needs to go back and ask for forgiveness in that same place. And I told her, even at the last minute, because we're going now in November 2nd. And she said, sir, I will go.
What about
my Muslims? That is, people like that has not made their dwelling place, God their dwelling place.
You go on your body, what if it just to
share you? And the third one I want to share with you.
Example better.
We had a big service today. The church was powerful.
And I
preached for about 50 minutes. And we prayed and prayed after that. And the celebrant asked that if she could use my garden for the celebration. They had a marquee there all set up. And as I was going, just to go there and pray with them before rushing here. But everything should be done in a fitting and orderly way.
chef making chef.
What we want to take and take and take and take.
Bon, avant de commander,
and not give.
Commencez pour moi.
And my question to you today is this. What do you have to offer God?
Qu'il est mis pour l'homme.
What do you have to offer God?
Qu'il est mis de faire pour l'homme.
You cannot go to God empty handed.
Il en est faux pour voir ce que l'homme.
Luke chapter 6 verse 13 makes it clear.
That
when you give God, when you abide in Him, when you walk with Him, He will give to you. And let me just read it. Give and it will be given to you. A good measure pressed down, shaking together and rolling over, will be poured into your lap. I pray you will come back to you in full measure. Beloved, if you abide in the Lord, you always receive mercy. If you remember the parable of the two men who prayed in Luke's gospel, chapter 8, verses 10 to 14. Chapter 8, verses 10 to 14. Chapter 18, 10-14. If you remember, the Pharisees did not go to the temple to pray to God. The Pharisees did not go to the temple to pray to God. But when they pronounced how good He was, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week.
And
give a tenth of all I get. You can see that he is not abiding in the Lord. That
he
is not walking with the Lord. That he is not doing the will of God. But then the tax collector. Mercy on me, a sinner. And you know what? Despite his sins,
even though
mercy was granted him.
And he ran.
I said the Lord will grant somebody here today his mercy and compassion. In the name of Jesus. What about the criminals at home with Jesus? In Luke's Gospel, chapter 23,
in Luke 23,
verses 39 to 43.
Open day 40.
One of them, on his way to hell, met his Lord. He recognized Jesus. He accepted Jesus. Because he asked for mercy. And he abides in the Lord. He said, Jesus, remember
me
when you come in your kingdom. And Jesus answered him, I tell you the truth. Today, you'll be with me in
paradise.
Praise the Lord. My sisters and brothers, abide in the Lord now. Turn to God now. So that your life will be much more useful and fulfilling. Remember what you sow. When you abide in the Lord, you will reap. When you give him what he wants, he will abide in you. That Let me just read from Galatians 6, 7 to 9.
Galatians 7, 9.
Do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. A man reaps what he sows. The one who sows to please his sinful nature, from that nature will reap destruction. Let us not become weary in doing good. For at the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. So as I bring this to an end, every action has results.
Lonely consequence, lonely.
I pray that you will not plan to please your own desires.
I do have been praying you will not sow lati jerezi no arati.
You see, to do so is to reap a crop of sorrow and evil. So again, I ask you, what kind of seeds are you sowing? And I urge you, I beg you, my dear friends,
who
abide in the Lord, begin to plan to please God. Walk with the Lord. Allow the Lord to stay with you. And as you do so, I pray you reap joy and everlasting life. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 5, verses 1 to 7,
Luke 35, 1 to 7,
the Bible tells us that Simon Peter, who had become a failure, because he worked hard all night and caught no fish. But because he sold his boats to Jesus. Because he obeyed Jesus, the Bible tells us that he later caught a large number of fish. That his nets began to break. As you abide in the Lord, I pray that miracles will happen in your life. My dear friends, you cannot afford to miss heaven.
You cannot afford
to miss the court. If you want to make the heavenly harvest, then you must abide in the Lord. So that the Lord will abide in you. I urge you to present yourself as a living sacrifice of thanksgiving to God by making of your body a temple for God to dwell in. Allow your tongue to speak God's praise. Allow your hands to do God's will. And I pray that when darkness deepens, when other helpers fail you, when there is no one to comfort you, the helpless will abide with you. When
heart's
joy grows deep for you, when change and care is all around you,
you get the point.
The God who changes now will abide in you.
I'm abiding
every passing hour.
the
presence of God. He will be your guide. And he will stay with you. And through cloud and sunshine, the Lord will abide in you. In life and in death, the Lord will abide with you. So my dear friends, congratulations. And I wish you a happy harvest.
We wish you a happy harvest.
So this new year, harvest year, learn to abide in the Lord. Learn to stay with the Lord. Learn to walk with the Lord. So that the blessing of harvest will be yours this day and always. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I want to see. increase.
Increase. But what should many people of every family of Obama?
So that you should
read. Every family of Obama.
Fear on a power phone.
Well,
fear on a power phone.
You are reading another version of the Bible.
Thank you. Channel. Hello.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Channel. It's not a...